IT admins have a huge set of tasks to handle every day. This includes checking for available disk space, rebooting a slow device, running maintenance checks, sending an escalation email, or logging a ticket, and more. Most of these tasks are mundane, repetitive IT issues that can be fixed using standard procedures. These level one troubleshooting steps and repetitive maintenance tasks can be orchestrated and automated using the Smart IT Workflow Automation Engine in OpManager.
For illustration, let's consider an example. I need to check if I have sufficient free space on my server. If free space on my server goes below 90 gigabytes, my logs won't get stored or some of my processes will slow down. So I need to manually check my server space daily.
But there is a better way. I can just set up an OpManager workflow. Let me show you how to automate these tasks using the workflow builder in OpManager. To create a workflow, click the Workflow tab, then select New Workflow in the top right corner of the page. These workflows are easy to use. Simply drag and drop the required actions from the left pane. There are a variety of actions for services, processes, HTTP and FTP protocols, files, folders, VMware, OpManager, external actions, and network configuration manager actions. You can add any number of actions and create workflows based on your specific requirements. Under Folder, select Check Drive Free Space. Drag and drop to the Workflow Builder screen.
Add the network device you want the workflow to run for. In my case, it is my server. Choose destination device, name of the server, and select the condition for which the workflow should execute for. In my case, I want OpManager to alert me when free space on my server is less than 90 gigabytes. Click OK.
When this condition is met, I want OpManager to generate an alarm. So I set up the Generate Alarm action under OpManager Actions in the left pane. I also customize fields to help me understand the alarm severity and more. After creating your workflow, click Next Step and select the Device Selection tab. Filter by category if needed, then select the required devices from the Available Devices column and move them to the Selected Devices column. Next, select Configure Trigger. You can select Alarm Trigger to start this workflow upon an event failure, or select Schedule Trigger to start this workflow on the schedule you define. Select the preferred time window. Click Next, provide a suitable workflow name, and click Save. This workflow will be executed immediately after OpManager triggers an alarm on the conditions violation for the selected device. OpManager also stores workflow results for reference. Selecting the Workflow Logs tab provides information about the workflow name, the time tasks were executed, the status of the workflow, and more. That's it for now. We hope this helps you manage your IT infrastructure better. For more information about workflows in OpManager, refer to the links in the description below. Thanks for watching. To stay up to date with the latest videos exploring OpManager's features, subscribe to our channel, OpManager Tech Videos.